Hi everyone, welcome back to Harish Educational Academy. In this video, we are going to learn about the summary of the poem The Old Huntsman written by William Wordsworth. William Wordsworth was born on April 7, 1770, England. His mother died when he was 7. He was an orphan at 13. Despite these losses, he did well at Hawkshead Grammar School, where he wrote his first poetry. He went on study at Cambridge University. He was died on April 23, 1850. This poem depicts a story of an old huntsman. He was dealing with old age and absence of everything he possessed in his prime days. He was gifted with great physique and speed, but in his later life he lost not only his youth but fame, friends, animals and resources. The poet narrates his story and describes his encounter with the old man and aiding him and earning his praise and gratitude. Hope all of you understood the theme of the poem here. The main character name is Simon and his wife is Ruth. Here the old man name is Simon, his wife name is Ruth. In this poem we come across these two characters only. Let us see the story. An old huntsman lived in the town of Cattigan. For 30 years, nearly 35 years he lived there. He was a successful huntsman in his time. His physique too was tall, which diminished with time, and now he is an old little man. He was a productive huntsman who never had to talk, who never had to take agriculture work to support him. Here, this old man lived in the Cardigan village for about 35 years. And he was a successful huntsman. Huntsman means those who hunt animals along with hounds. He's having good physique at that time, tall personality, but now he became old. And his magnificent ruled by the vicinity, his horns hollow, echoed through his hills and valleys, instructing his hounds in their pursuit of the hunt. So while he was going to hunt, whenever he made sound, it echoes. That means that much of energy he has when he was young. Simon was the first riser in the morning and brought the villagers out of sleep with his activeness. So he was so active when he was young. He was the first person rise in the village. He is known as a fast runner who could beat not only other men but animals like horse also. That means he can run as fast as horse. Besides, he is blind, yet he found his joy in his hound's growling. So besides, when he became old, even though he cannot see properly, he can get joy from his hound's growling. He is all alone and old age has surrounded him and stripped him of all his physical and mental vigor. And now he became old. He cannot move here and there as quickly as he was in his youth. Moreover, he has no adequate means and leads impoverished life. That means he has no money. He did not earn much money to lead the life when he was young. His patron and master is gone too, and his abode is inactive now. Now he is not at all active. And it is unfortunate for Simon as neither he has his earlier strength nor he has employment. Now the person Simon has no employment and no strength also. All his companions and friends, including animals, dogs and horses, are long dead. Old age has weakened his body, leaving it sick and dwindled with him. Now he is very sick. He cannot move quickly and he became became very weak. His ankles has grown swollen and legs become thin. His only support is in the world is his aged wife. Both lives near the waterfall in the village. He has no other asset other than the piece of land. He acquired it when he was a powerful man, but this land is of no use because he cannot do the cultivation work. His wife has comparatively more strength than him, so she worked out some task which he is unable to do. But the difference in their energy is very little, so she also cannot do heavy work. The narrator now addresses to the readers about the old man's falling health. His daily struggles take its toll on him. The narrator is aware of the reader's expectation of the climax of this sad tale. He then points out that the readers are always keen on finding story in everything. He wants to make them aware hard about it. He further reveals that this is not a tale, this is not a story. It's mere attribution of reader's mind, giving meaning to it and making a story out of it. So he made this real incident as a story to attract the readers. He reveals that he met this old man in summer. Finally, he revealed the story. William Wordsworth met that old man in summer. He was trying to uproot the root of an old tree with a mattock, an agriculture tool. So the old man is trying to uproot the root of an old tree with an agriculture tool. The narrator noticed that the old man's strength is so feeble that it would take a lifetime to unearth the root of the land. He requests the old man to give him the tool and let him do it for him. So Wordsworth thought that the old man cannot do that work, so he asked the old man to give him the tool to help him. The old man accepts his help and narrator strike the root out of in a single blow. The old man is joyful at this help by the narrator and tears begin to flow from his eyes. He praises him and expresses his gratitude. At this, a thought across the narrator's mind, he ponders about the men who don't express gratitude or kindness done to them. But it is the gratitude of people that makes him mournful. So here